Hello, this is the Unstoppable podcast show for forward-thinking, driven and ambitious female entrepreneurs and creators. And we are here joined today with the beautiful Sandra Dawes. How are you, Sandra?
I'm well, thanks. How are you?
I am so well. Thank you so much for coming on and chatting with us today and hopefully giving lots of inspiration and some clarity to the people out there listening today about what it is that you do and what they could do to make their life and business a little bit easier too. So let us into a little bit of an idea about what you actually do at the moment, Sandra.
So I like to refer to myself as a recovering control freak and excuse maker. And that's what I help women overcome as well, those challenges, because I know them intimately. Mm-hmm. And I know how challenging it can be to want big things for your life, but struggle with the mental chatter that tells you that it's impossible, that you shouldn't, that it's not financially responsible for you to quit your job and do the things you want to do, and those kinds of things. So it's really about helping them, you know, with the mindset piece, with helping them create daily habits that support them in a positive way so that they can stay focused on the things that are important to them, and just helping them, you know, set boundaries and priorities and all those things, because they're so important to really making those big, hairy, audacious goals a reality.
Yeah, absolutely. I was just going to say something there that you picked, that you mentioned, which is really important, I think. When it comes to the way that we're conditioned to think that we go school, college, uni, whatever, and straight yeah,
in. Totally.
There has never been a kind of chat I can remember back at school thinking, you know, you could be an entrepreneur.
Never.
Why don't you go into something you actually genuinely adore and love? There was never that. What do you think is the kind of biggest sticking point for women when they are possibly, you know, maybe really, really miserable in their job? They know it's not their calling. They know it's not the thing they should be doing. Or maybe they're just kind of a little bit of a wit's end with their work, and they're thinking, I just don't feel this anymore. Like, I don't want to be here.
Right.
The thing is stopping women from going, do you know what? I am going to take that risk financially, spiritually, you know, whatever. I'm going to take that risk and I'm going to do something that I love. What do you think is the biggest problem?
I think it's because many of us have that people-pleasing nature, and we don't know how that's going to be received from our family. If, you know, whether if you spend a lot of money on your post-secondary, and you, it's like, so you spent all this money and all this time getting an education, and now you want to do what? Yeah. And then it's the how, like, is it, am I doing the responsible thing? Especially if you're married and or you have kids and you've got other responsibilities. Now it's like, well, I have to stay here because how am I? How will I know if I can pay my bills? How will I know that I can support my family? And so those are the things that I think hold us back, is that the reality of it. And so there's that fear that if I really pursue the things that I want to in my life, that if it goes completely left on me, I'll be left homeless and won't be able to take care of my family and that sort of thing. And that fear, I think, is sometimes so powerful that it supersedes all of the dreams that we have.
100%. And I think that is the word, isn't it? It's the fear factor, which is the thief.
Yes. Killer of dreams.
Incredible big business that could possibly be built, isn't it? It is. It's the killer of dreams completely. So I know that we dived in there, and I want to kind of go back to your beginning though, Sandra. I'm really intrigued by, you know, your journey as well up until this point. So can you let us know a little bit about, you know, what was like growing up for you? Have you always been entrepreneurial spirited, or is it something that you've came to later on?
Oh, definitely came to later on. I, as you said, you know, go to school, get a job, get the pension and the, maybe the corner office if you're lucky kind of thing, right? And so yeah, I grew up in a family of workers, you know, nobody had, you know, the entrepreneurial spirit. And so yeah, I was the first generation to go to university. So that was a big thing. So it wasn't, are you going to go to university or what are you going to do when you graduate from high school? It was like, so you're going to go, you know, that's it. There was no negotiation, none of that. And so I did. And again, I grew up an only child, and I Yeah, and so I felt like it was my duty and obligation to do what my parents wanted to, you know, fulfill their dreams for me. And so that was the path that I was on for a really long time. And then my father passed away in 2004. And I still say I'm a complete daddy's girl because he was such a big part of my life. But I feel like emotionally, he was my rock. You know, he was my go-to. He was the person I talked to about the fact that I was once again in a job I really hated and I don't know what to do and that kind of thing. But it was never a conversation about, you know, maybe you should start your own business. It was always, well, just look for another job kind of thing.
Absolutely.
Right? And but when he died, I felt like, you know, my whole world had fallen apart. And I think that it sort of shifted my concept of my reality, because again, I was such a people pleaser. I was always trying to do everything for everybody else, and I never really thought about what I wanted to do for myself. And so when I lost him, and then, you know, you have these expectations of the support that you should get and that kind of thing, and the people who are going to come around for you because you were there for them, and it didn't quite work out that way, you know, and it sort of gave me that the shift that I needed to really say, okay, so you got to stop waiting on other people to boost you up, to support you, to love you even, you know. And so it was really just, it just started a whole journey of self-awareness, of self-love, because I was so devastated and my relationship with my mom was never good and it completely went south after he died. And so I felt lost and I went to therapy. They tried to put me on antidepressants and I was like, I don't think, I felt like if there was ever going to be a point where I would become addicted to something because I was reaching so much, that that would have been the time.
Yeah.
So I, you know, went on the spiritual journey. You know, I had gotten to that crisis point, and because I am a book lover, so somebody recommended reading Esther Hicks, you know, the law of attraction. And so I just like dove into the self-help part of the bookstore in a massive way, and found Wayne Dyer and Deepak Chopra and Louise Hay. And it was, and I felt like my world had just, you know, expanded in ways that I didn't even imagine before. And so when I got to a point in my life where I was again in a job that didn't feel right anymore, and I was out there doing what I always do, which is just look for another job. And it didn't quite work out because I was getting second and third interviews, but never getting the job. And it was getting really frustrating. But I was doing the work. I was, you know, trying to figure stuff out. I was meditating, journaling, and doing all these things. And then one day while walking the dog, like this voice just came to me and said, well, what about coaching? And it was so odd because, I mean, the voice was so clear, but I was out on the road walking the dog and she doesn't talk. So where did this voice come from?
It's amazing, though, the inner subconscious, it's so much powerful.
And it was, and I felt like it was, it couldn't have been a subtle message. It had to be, this is the answer kind of thing. Yeah. And so I wasn't even really clear on what a coach was at that point, but I had had a friend who had just hired one. And you know, synchronicities happened, and there was an opportunity to go to a workshop that was being run by a coach and a yoga instructor, and I went with her. And then on the drive home, I decided to confess that this was something that I, that was in my mind, and I wasn't quite sure why. And I think I was expecting her to say, oh, that's crazy, you should, you know, figure something else out. And her response was that it made total sense to her. And so I had to ask why. And she said that she felt like I had been coaching her for free for as long as we'd known each other. Wow. And so it was one of those things where I felt like I had to do more. And I think that it was the most proactive I've ever been about a career choice, because after her saying that, I needed to figure it out. So I interviewed the coach that ran the workshop we had just attended. I interviewed her coach and then decided to hire a coach of my own and go through the whole process. And it was in that work that I did with my coach that I decided to start Embrace Your Destiny and start the entrepreneurial journey, which was something I never ever imagined I would do.
It's incredible. What an amazing, amazing story. Out of adversity, you've actually found the thing that you were called probably in.
Right. Yeah, and I spent 10 years in the nonprofit sector, so I always knew that helping people was where I wanted to be. It was just a matter of getting clarity on what that looked like and was supposed to be for me.
Yeah, incredible. So tell me, what do women, or is it men and women you work with, or
primarily women?
Yeah, so when women come to you, what are a few of the things that you can actually help them with, Sandra?
It's really helping them to find the confidence to step outside their comfort zone. Yeah. Because, you know, if you want to achieve those big things, you can't continue to do the things you've done, you know, in the same way, right? You're going to have to put yourself out there, and you're going to have to do the scary things in order to really see what's possible. And so it's about, you know, finding ways to help them, you know, take those baby steps to get to where they want to be, so that they can see, you know, small results, see those mini successes and say, okay, it's not so bad. So let's see what else is possible. And I think that that's what it really is about, is taking that action and seeing that, you know, it's not the end of the world. And even if it doesn't work out, there are lessons to gain from that. And it's just about taking those lessons and moving forward and just staying focused on the goal itself.
Amazing. I can imagine that a lot of the women that come to you as well, and especially me, sometimes find it hard to maybe prioritize things in their life, because I know that when I was going through my journey, I was a mum, a daughter, a sister, every person I could be to everyone.
So many roles.
Yeah, that. But also be like the CEO of my business and really forward hitting with that too, was really, really hard. And I found it so difficult to set the boundaries on as well. And even just up till the kind of latter part of, you know, last year, the boundaries when it comes to my clients too, because I am so...
You want to give so much.
Give so much, like just take all of me. But of course, your family have to have you as well, and your friends and things like that. So I would love to chat a little bit about, you know, what your experience has been when it comes to setting boundaries in your own life, because I know that that is some things that you help women with as well, isn't it?
Yes. I think that, it started with understanding that people pleasing wasn't something that I could continue to do without, you know, incorporating some self-care as well. And I think that probably the best advice that I got in my interviews with the coaches was that you cannot give from an empty cup. And I think that that is what sticks in my mind all the time. And so it's about understanding that if you want to be of service to others, you have to take time out for yourself. And there's nothing wrong with making yourself a priority, because if you don't, then, and you're not at your best, then you can't give your best to anybody else in your life. So I think that, I mean, I think years ago, I actually wrote a blog post where I said selfishness is the greatest gift you can give yourself and others. Because if you're not taking care of yourself, then how can you be the best mom you can be, or the best spouse you can be, or the best daughter you can be? Because when they need you and you're at the verge of a breakdown because you've been trying to be everything to everybody, then you're going to let these people down, and it's going to be disappointing for you and for them. So you have to really find the time to make time for yourself, to do the things that are going to fulfill you, to keep you sustained mentally, spiritually, physically, emotionally, because if you don't make the time for that, then everything else is going to suffer.
Absolutely. What do you think are the actual biggest challenges people have when they are trying to get clear on how to prioritize and what to prioritize as well?
I think that sometimes it's about not even really having clarity on the vision of what you want for your life. Like, what is the big picture? Yeah. And so that's why a lot of times I start off with suggesting to do the vision board or your bucket list, or one of the exercises I like to do that people always kind of cringe at is writing your obituary. Like, how do you want to be remembered, right? Because a lot of times we have these legacies that we want to create, but we think that we have all the time in the world to do it. And the truth of the matter is, as morbid as it sounds, is we just never know. So there's no time like the present to start creating that legacy. And so if you have these things that you want to be remembered for, whether it's being, you know, an amazing present mother or whatever that is, and you're not, and you feel like you're not doing that right now, then those are the things that you need to start to work on and make those things a priority, because you can't wait 10, 20, 15 years to build those legacies. It starts now, right? So once you're clear on what that big vision, what that, you know, that big picture is for your life, then you can start to look at how you're living your life right now and be be honest about whether or not the things you're doing are helping to create that legacy or completely off track.
I can remember when I have been coming up against my fears of taking things forward, of expanding, of growth, of scaling, things like that. I always think now that the fear of not having that as part of my legacy
yes.
is clear, and the fear of not having the success that is like my own unique version of what success looks like to yeah. me is scarier than the actual fear that I've got in that instant where
take the action. Yeah.
And by doing that and having that little moment, you know, well, I can sit with this fear just now and be totally terrified to take this next piece of action. Or I can also think, okay, if I don't do it, what is the consequence of that?
Yeah.
Normally that thing is always much scarier than yes. the fear that you're sitting with for a little while. Yeah,
exactly.
So incredible. So so thank you so much. Just so much value there in such a short space of time. It's incredible. I know that you have got an incredible free gift that you can give to people today as well. Can you talk to us a little bit about that and where we can go and find it, please?
So it's a workbook designed to help you really get clear on your priorities if that's where you're stuck. If you feel like you're getting pulled in every direction but the right one, and you're saying yes to everything, and you know that you need to start to say no, so you need help setting those boundaries, that workbook is going to help you do that. And actually, if you go to my website, which is embraceyourdestiny.ca, it's the first thing you'll see is a page that talks about the workbook, and you can sign up to get it.
Absolutely brilliant. And can you tell us, is there anywhere, so social media wise, is there a community group? What else do you have going on that we can come and find you, Sandra?
I've got Embrace Your Destiny is all the handles for Instagram, Facebook, everything like that. And I do have an Embrace Your Destiny Facebook group as well. And it's just all about tips and tools to help you stay on track about goals and the mindset pieces that, you know, keep us held back from really doing the things that we want to do, and supporting each other in getting past those roadblocks. Because I look at, you know, our goals is sort of like a road trip, right? And so you hit those obstacles, and it doesn't mean that you give up on getting to that final destination. It just means you have to find an alternate route to get there, right? So it's just about supporting the group and really supporting each other and celebrating those accomplishments as well, because I think that that's something that we sometimes forget to do is, you know, celebrate those small victories along the way.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, having the collaboration of other women that are on their own journey in this kind of space, in the entrepreneurial space, is so important, because I
definitely
find that it's not always your family and friends that are your biggest supporters.
No, because they often don't get it.
They don't do, and that's fantastic. But in my experience, a lot of my family just don't understand what I even do.
Yeah.
What do you even do? I need to go get a real job.
Right.
You know, and so to have a community of other women that are kind of there, and they've got your back, and they know the struggles themselves, but they also yeah. wins and how incredible that can feel is perfect. So an amazing community space that I hope, if you're all listening, you will go and join with Sandra for that group. You also just kicked on something else that is really important, and it's that thing about saying no.
Yes.
Saying no is...
It's okay.
Isn't it?
And sometimes it's necessary. And I remember once hearing somebody speak, and she said, you know, she's like, no can be a full and complete sentence. You know, you don't have to, you know, explain yourself and, you know, come up with all these justifications why you're saying no. You can just say no, and that's it. And I love that, because I felt like for a long time, I always felt like I had to justify why I was
saying no. Now I find myself doing it. You know, I'll say, oh no, I don't really have a lot of time. And I'm like, no, no is fine.
Yeah.
Why are you digging a hole now?
It's probably not going to make them feel any better about the no.
Back to the yes, you know, it's like, no, oh, well, maybe. And then it becomes a yes. It's like, that's not the point. The point is no, you need to focus on what you're doing and prioritize yourself.
Yeah. Because there's no point in doing stuff and then, you know, feeling resentful about it or it not going well because your heart isn't into it and that sort of thing. So it's just best to leave it at no and keep it moving.
Sandra, it's been an absolute pleasure to have you on the show today. Thank you so much. Just remember, everyone, if you are looking to find out more information about Sandra Dawes and what she does, it is www.embraceyourdestiny.ca. You can find her over there. And thank you so much, Sandra.
Thanks for having me.
You are so welcome. I can't wait to collaborate possibly in the future as well. You're an extremely inspirational entrepreneur. I'm looking forward to following your journey as well.
Oh, thank you.
So thank you, everyone that's out there listening today. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are in the world. Thank you so much for being a part of this Unstoppable community and listening to this podcast. Make sure you're spreading the word and shouting about what we do. And of course, remember, if you would like to appear on this podcast, you can just look at the links below. Not only can you find Sandra there, but you can also find out information about Unstoppable. Thank you so much, everyone, for listening, and I will speak to you real soon.